Let's open our Bible to the book of Deuteronomy 8. Deuteronomy 8. Let us open our Bible to Deuteronomy 8. Not forgetting Yahweh. Not forgetting Yahweh. Deuteronomy 8 verses 1 to 9. Exhortations and cautions enforced by the Lord's former dealings with Israel and his promises. Verse 1. In this chapter of Deuteronomy, Moses warns the people of God of the ease with which they can forget Yahweh and his great kindnesses to them. He urges them to be careful not to do so, but to remember Yahweh and all that he has done. Verses 2 to 5. This generation has much to remember. They have just finished long years in the wilderness, which were necessary, after all, only because their parents had rebelled against Yahweh and faithlessly refused to trust his promise to bring them into Canaan in triumph, even though he had brought them so miraculously and triumphantly out of the bondage of Egypt. They should also remember how often they had tested Yahweh and complained against him, and how, nevertheless, he patiently and generously met their needs with manna, clothing, and fatherly discipline. Verses 6 to 9. The appropriate response to what God had done, Moses points out, is to obey him, walk with him, and give reverence to him. And God's blessings are not simply part of Israel's history. At that moment, God was in the process of bringing Israel into a good land of their own. Obedience must be first careful. Observe to do what he asked to do. Second, universal, to do all the commandments. And third, from a good principle. Obedience has to be from a good principle, with a regard to God as the Lord, and regard to God as your God, as their God, and with a holy fear of him. To engage them in this obedience, Moses directs them to look back. It is good to remember all the ways, both of Yahweh's providence and grace, by which he has led us through this wilderness, that we may cheerfully serve him and trust in him. They must remember the straits they were sometimes brought into for mortifying their pride and manifesting their perverseness, to prove them that they and others might know all that was in their heart, and that all might see that God chose them, not for anything in them which might recommend them to his favor. They must remember the miraculous supplies of food and clothing granted them. Let none of God's children distrust their father, nor take any sinful course for the supply of their necessities. Some way or other, God will provide for them in the way of duty and honest diligence. And verily, verily, they shall be fed. This may be applied spiritually. The word of God is the food of the soul. Christ is the word of God. By him we live. They must also remember the rebukes they had been under, and not without need. This use we should make of all our afflictions by them let us be quickened to our duty. Moses also directs them to look forward to Canaan. Look which way we will, both to look back and to look forward to Canaan. Look which way we will, both to look back and to look forward, will furnish earth with arguments for obedience. Moses saw in that land a type of the better country. The gospel church is the New Testament Canaan, watered with the Spirit, the Holy Spirit, in his gifts and graces, planted with trees of righteousness, bearing fruits of righteousness. Heaven is the good land in which nothing is wanting and where is fullness of joy. What we have in the world, we must acknowledge God's property in and dispose of it as before him with justice and charity and dependence upon providence. The heavenly Canaan is described to us in the scriptures, and there are in it mansions and portions sufficient for all God's spiritual Israel, as we see in John 14 verses 1 to 3. Christ is our Joshua. Our Joshua, as we see in Joshua 18, verse 6, our Joshua who divides it to us, the land, divides it to us. In him we must attend, and to him we must apply for an inheritance with the saints in light. For the new Canaan, the New Testament Canaan, is the gospel Canaan, the body of Christ, the kingdom of God on earth, as it is said in John 17 verses 2 to 3. Deuteronomy 8 verses 10 to 20, exhortations and cautions further enforced. Verses 10 to 14, Yahweh's blessings of prosperity, it seems, come with their own temptations to become proud and forget Yahweh. Two great and dangerous temptations. Verses 15 to 18, to emphasize his point, Moses again reiterates what God has done and that which Israel is to remember. How true all of God's promises had proven themselves to be. How safely Israel had lived according to the word of God. It was not by their own skill or effort or endurance that they had managed these long years in the desert, but by the goodness and provision of God. All of this was fresh in their minds as they sat poised in the esteem in the eastern bank of the Jordan, ready to cross and possess the promised land. Verses 19 to 20, if you are going to live a faithful life, Moses tells the Israelites, then make a determined and heartfelt effort to keep God's commandments for love's sake. The kind of remembering Moses is speaking of here is that which stirs the heart, breaks pride and willfulness, and awakens faith, hope, and love. Moses directs to the duty of a prosperous condition. Let them always remember their benefactor. In everything we must give thanks. Moses arms them against the temptations of a prosperous condition. When men possess large estates or are engaged in profitable business, they find the temptation to pride, forgetfulness of God, and carnal mindedness very strong, and they are anxious and troubled about many things. In this, the believing poor have the advantage. They more easily perceive their supplies coming from Yahweh in answer to the prayer of faith. And strange as it may seem, they find less difficulty in simply trusting him for daily bread. And they taste the sweetness in it, which is generally unknown to the rich, while they are also freed from many of their temptations. Forget not God's former dealings with thee. Here is the great secret of divine providence. Infinite wisdom and goodness are the source of all the changes and trials believers experience. Israel had many bitter trials, but it was between quote to do them good, end of quote. Pride is natural to the human heart. Would one suppose that such a people, after their slavery in the brick kilns, should need the thorns of the wilderness to humble them? But such is man, and they were proved that they might be humbled. None of us live a single week without giving proofs of our weaknesses, folly, and depravity. The broken-hearted souls alone, the Savior is precious indeed. To broken-hearted souls alone, the Savior is precious. Nothing can render the most suitable outward and inward trials effectual but the power of the Spirit of God. See here how God's giving and our getting are reconciled, and apply it to the spiritual wealth. All God's gifts are in pursuance of his promises. Moses repeats the warning he had often given of the fatal consequences of forsaking God. Those who follow others in sin will follow them to destruction. If we do as sinners do, we must expect to fear as sinners fear. Know this. And the Lord Yahweh will bless you. Amen. Hallelujah. Let us take these prayer points. Let us pray for bonding with Yahweh. I will not fall into the ease with which people of God can forget Yahweh and His great kindness to them. Thank you, Lord, all to your glory. In the mighty name of Yeshua the Messiah, we pray. The Lord humbled me, causing me to hunger, and then feeding me with manna. Thank you, Lord, all to your glory. In the mighty name of Yeshua the Messiah, we pray. Yahweh taught me that man does not live on bread alone, but on every word that comes from the mouth of Yahweh. Thank you, Lord, all to your glory. In the mighty name of Yeshua the Messiah, we pray. My clothes did not wear out, and my feet did not swell during my wilderness. Thank you, Lord, all to your glory. In the mighty name of Yeshua the Messiah, we pray. I know then in my heart that as a man disciplines his son, so Yahweh, my God, disciplines me. Thank you, Lord, all to your glory. In the mighty name of Yeshua the Messiah, we pray. I will observe the commands of Yahweh, my God, walking in obedience to him and revering him. Thank you, Lord. All to your glory. In the mighty name of Yeshua the Messiah, we pray. For Yahweh, my God, is bringing me into a good land, a land with brooks, streams, and deep springs gushing out into the valleys and hills. Thank you, Lord. All to your glory. In the mighty name of Yeshua the Messiah, we pray. Yahweh, my God, is bringing me into a land with wheat and barley, vines and fig trees, pomegranates, olive oil, and honey. Thank you, Lord. All to your glory. In the mighty name of Yeshua the Messiah, we pray. Yahweh, my God, is bringing me into a land where bread will not be scarce, and I will lack nothing. Thank you, Lord. All to your glory. In the mighty name of Yeshua the Messiah, we pray. Yahweh, my God, is bringing me into a land where the rocks are iron and you can dig copper out of the hills. Thank you, Lord. All to your glory. In the mighty name of Yeshua the Messiah, we pray. When I have eaten and am satisfied, I will praise Yahweh, my God, for the good land he has given me. I will be careful that I do not forget Yahweh, my God. Thank you, Lord. All to your glory. In the mighty name of Yeshua the Messiah, we pray. Father Yahweh, I will not fail to observe your commands, your laws, and your decrees. Thank you, Lord. All to your glory. In the mighty name of Yeshua the Messiah, we pray. Otherwise, I eat and am satisfied. When I build fine houses and settle down, then my heart may become proud. Thank you, Lord. All to your glory. In the mighty name of Yeshua the Messiah, we pray. Otherwise, when my herds and flocks grow large and my silver and gold increase and all I have is multiplied, then I may forget Yahweh, my God, who brought me out of the land of slavery. Thank you, Lord. All to your glory. In the mighty name of Yeshua the Messiah, we pray. Yahweh, let me through the vast and dreadful wilderness. Thank you, Lord. All to your glory. In the mighty name of Yeshua the Messiah, we pray. He led me through that thirsty and waterless land with its venomous snakes and scorpions. Thank you, Lord. All to your glory. In the mighty name of Yeshua the Messiah, we pray. Yahweh brought me water out of the rock. Thank you, Lord. All to your glory. In the mighty name of Yeshua the Messiah, we pray. He gave me manna to eat in the wilderness, to humble and test me, so that in the end it might go well with me. Thank you, Lord. All to your glory. In the mighty name of Yeshua the Messiah, we pray. I may say to myself, my power and the strength of my hands have produced this wealth for me. Thank you, Lord. All to your glory. In the mighty name of Yeshua the Messiah, we pray. But I will remember Yahweh my God, for it is He who gives me the ability to produce wealth. Thank you, Lord. All to your glory. In the mighty name of Yeshua the Messiah, we pray. Yahweh so confirms His covenant, which His word, He swore to my ancestors as it is today. Thank you, Lord. All to your glory. In the mighty name of Yeshua the Messiah, we pray. I will never forget Yahweh my God and follow other gods and worship and bow down to them. Thank you, Lord. All to your glory. In the mighty name of Yeshua the Messiah, we pray. For if I do it, I will surely be destroyed. Thank you, Lord. All to your glory. In the mighty name of Yeshua the Messiah, we pray. Like the nations, Yahweh destroyed before me, so I will be destroyed for not obeying Yahweh my God. Thank you, Lord. All to your glory. In the mighty name of Yeshua the Messiah, we pray. For those who follow others in sin will follow them to destruction. Thank you, Lord. All to your glory. In the mighty name of Yeshua the Messiah, we pray. And if I do as sinners do, I must expect to fear as sinners fear. Thank you, Lord. All to your glory. In the mighty name of Yeshua the Messiah, we pray. Thank you, Father Yahweh, that you heard our prayers. Thank you, Lord, for your answers to our prayers. Father Yahweh, we give you glory, we give you honor, we give you all the praise. In the mighty name of Yeshua the Messiah, we pray. Amen. Hallelujah.